So now it's time to start our discussion about enum classes, but first I'm going to copy our user class inside our classes file. Now I'm going to delete this class, and also I'm going to delete the code inside the main function. Now, what are enum classes? Enum classes are used when you want to represent a fixed set of values. So when you want to represent, when you want to create some constants, you should use enums, because enums are like constants, but they are more powerful because they can have properties and they can also have functions. And enums are usually used in if conditionals or in if statements or in the when statement, or if you want to call it the if statement expression or when statement expression. Now, let's see how you can create an enum class. And to create an enum class, you just type here enum, the keyword enum. And as I'm typing, I have some suggestions. Then we put class, and let's call this enum class directions. Direction, actually. Then we put curly braces, and inside the enum class direction, we define our enum values. So here we define north, we put comma, enter, south, you can put them in one line just to have comma between them, east, and west. Right? So we have our enums values defined inside our direction enum class, and those enums values that we have here, they are instances of our enum class direction. So they are an instance, they are an object created inside the enum class direction, just that they have this different name. And as you can see, the name of the enum values should be, all the names should be in uppercase letters. Now, let's see how we can access those enum values. To access the enum values, we can, let's put the println here. We type direction, then we press dot, and we have some suggestions here. We have west, east, north, and south. So we have our enum values suggested. So let's choose west. And let's output this in the console. So we get west. So this is the enum value west. And let's press Control D. Let's change this to east. So let's change this to east. Let's change this to north and south. Now if you run this code, we get our enum values, west, east, north, and south. So this is how you can get the enum values that you define inside your enum class. Now we can define a constructor here for our enum class and define some properties like var, let's call it direction of type string, and var distance, and this is going to be an integer. Now if you hover over here, you have some underlines, and the underlines, if you hover over, it says that enum has not default constructor. So now, because as I said, those enums values are instances, they are objects created inside our enum class, now we need to pass some values to the properties that we define here. So let's pass some values here. So let's type here first north, and I'm gonna speed up this now a little bit. Alright, so now what we did here, we pass some values to the enum values constructors, because in our enum class direction, we define some properties. And those properties, because the enum values are objects, they are instances for enum directions, even though they have those different names, we need to pass to the constructors then some values. So we pass here north, south, east, west, and pass for the distance 10, 20, 50, and 40. Now, let's see how we can loop through our enums values. And to do that, we just delete this code. And what if, and here we add the for loop. So we type for. Let's call it the direction in, and here we type direction, our enum class, dot values. And this is gonna return an array with all the enum values that we define in our class. Now let's put curly braces and let's add a println. And let's print the direction. So now if you run this, you'll see the same output. But in the order that they are defined inside the class. So we see the same, not the same output, because they are outputted in the order in which they are defined in the class. So we have north, south, east, and west. And this is how we can loop through an enum, through the enum values of an enum class. So this is how we do it. So now let's delete this code. Now, if you want to access the arguments that are passed to our enum values constructors, we just first put a println to output the values in the console. And we type direction, so our enum class, dot. And we choose our enum value, let's choose north. And from here, and here now we type also dot. And now we have some suggestions. We have direction, distance. And we also have name. A name is a variable which is not defined by us. So we only define those properties, direction and distance. But name is a variable which is built in the enum class, similar to the direction that values, which return the array, is the direction that values. Values was also property, which actually it was an array property which was built into the enum class, so we didn't create that. It's provided by the enum class, so this is why we have that name there. So let's put direction, let's press Ctrl D, duplicate this code, and let's change this to distance. Let's press Ctrl D again, and let's also print that name, which is the built-in variable, which is the built-in variable provided by the enum class. So let's put here name. Now if we run this code, get north, so this is the value that we pass here, we get 10, and then we get north with capital letters. So we get the values that we passed here for direction and distance, which are defined in direction class. So we get the values passed for this specific enum value, and then we get north, and this is the built-in variable which is provided by you by the enum class. But as I said, you can also have functions. So let's have a function which returns the direction and distance. So let's type here fun. We call it print data because it's gonna print the data of a specific enum value. It's not gonna take any input. Put curly braces. But now we have an error here. That is because when you declare a function inside an enum class, you need to provide a semicolon for the last enum defined in your class. So you need to put here a semicolon, and the error disappeared. And let's print the data here. Let's add the println. Let's put quotation marks. Let's put direction equals dollar sign direction, and distance equals dollar sign distance. Now if you call this on our on a enum value, let's type direction dot, let's say west dot, and now we have our function print data. So this print data function is going to print the data of the west enum that is defined here. So it's going to output west and 40 in the console. So now if you run this code, we get direction west and distance 40. So this is how you can use functions inside Enum classes. Next, let's see how we can use our Enum direction and generally how we can use Enums with the when statement expression. So I'm going to close the console. I'm going to delete this code, and the print data function works for all of our Enum values. So let's delete this. And here I'm going to define a variable. It's going to be a val. It's going to be called direction. I'm going to put equals, and here we type direction, our Enum class. Let's choose east. So now the Enum actually east, no west, east. So now our direction Enum east is going to be stored in our direction variable. Let's use the when statement expression, and we type here when direction, then we put curly braces, and here we type direction dot east. We're gonna put arrow, execute this code. So println, the direction is east. And we'll do the same thing for the next one. So let's press Ctrl D. Let's change this to west. North and south. So this is how you can use the enums with the when statement. Now if I run this, actually I should change the text there, but I'm gonna change it. So let's close this to change the text here. Now if you run this, you're gonna see the direction is east because this condition is true. Our direction argument here is going to match with this branch, so it's going to evaluate true, and then it's going to execute this code. You can put curly braces if you want, but as I said in our discussion about the when statement expression, you should use curly braces if you have multiple lines of code. In our case, if you have one single line of code, but you can put curly braces if you want. And of course that this branch will always evaluate to true because here we type direction.east into our direction variable literally, directly. And this value doesn't change. But in a real app, this value could come from a database or from the user input. And in that case, you need to use a function which is also built into the Enum class. And that function is called valueOf. So we type direction.valueOf, and this valueOf function checks to see if our value that we pass here exists inside our Enum class. So it checks to see if it's defined here, and it also returns that value. So if I type here east, now if I run this code, we get an error which is no Enum constant direction that is, because all of our Enum values have they are defined in uppercase letters. But if I put here dot uppercase, and if I run this code, now we get the direction is east. And this value that we have here east, this value, as I said, could come from a database or from the user input. And direction that value of is going to check to see if this Enum value exists in our Enum class, and it's going to return that value in our variable. So it's going to assign that value to our variable. So see you in the next video.